اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم۔ یا ایہا الذین آمنوا کتب علیکم الصیام کما کتب علی الذین من قبلکم لعلکم تتقون۔ صدق اللہ العظیم۔ مائی ریسپیکٹڈ برادرز اینڈ مائی سسٹرز، ٹوڈے ان اے ویری شارٹ ٹاک آئی ووڈ لائک ٹو برنگ یور اٹینشن ٹوورڈز پریپریشن آف رمضان۔ لیٹس گیٹ ریڈی for Ramadan. You know, whenever we do anything important in our life, we plan ahead, we plan well, we want to be ready when the time comes. Ramadan is the most important time as a Muslim, important month of the year. Maulana Amin Hassan Islahi Sahab has said, you know, everything has its season. When you sow the seed in the season, then you can really get the right fruit, you can get the right results, you can benefit the most from that seed. Ramadan is the time of spiritual uplifting, spiritual growth, tazkiyah. Ramadan is all about transformation. That Quran is the book of transformation, change. That Quran wants to see change in our life. So for this important month of spiritual uplifting, spiritual growth, transformation, it's very important, my brothers and my sisters, that we should plan ahead, and we plan very well. So when the time starts, we are ready for it. We all have to have a mental picture first, that where we want to see ourselves after Ramadan. It's very important to have that mental picture so that you can plan what exactly you need to do to reach from point A to point B. See, if I will have my mental picture that I want to make sure that I improve my relationship with Quran, I improve my salah, I should have better understanding of Quran, then I can plan accordingly, and then I will be able to see the physical picture of that plan which I have executed during Ramadan, my brothers and my sisters. Make sure that you free yourself as much as possible during Ramadan. So try to accomplish any unfinished business you have before Ramadan, if possible. Don't start anything new during Ramadan if you can wait up until end of Ramadan. So there are many things, if we plan ahead, we can take care of those time consuming activities before Ramadan starts. Especially I will ask for my sisters, they have to do a lot of, you know, cooking and other stuff. If they can plan ahead, then inshallah they can spend more time, more quality time for ibadah during Ramadan. Same thing is for brothers. You know, work related things, your personal stuff, your business stuff, there are many things. If we plan ahead, like we plan, you know, if I have to go on a trip, I want to make sure I take care of many things before I start my journey. You know, during this Ramadan, brothers, we want to make sure that our Ramadan is simple and focused. If you go back and see Ramadan in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the beauty you will see of the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba and Tabi'in and Taba Tabi'in is that Ramadan was simple and focused. We have made Ramadan month of feast and festivity. Wallahi, this month is not about feast and festivity. This month is that we spend our time and we allow people who are around us to spend every second of their time during Ramadan in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I will request, don't spend time on too much of feast and festivity, you know, cooking varieties of food and spending too much time in kitchen and eating and night just in gossips. Rather, we should have our Ramadan simple and focused, my brothers and my sisters. You know, Ramadan is all about, as Maulana Amin Hassan Islahi Sahab has said, you know, rebellious horse. You want to learn how to control it, your nafs. You don't want to suppress your nafs, rather you want to learn skills that how you can control your nafs, and that is the best training during Ramadan. That's the way, if we really want to change ourselves, our personality, that how I can control. And look at the beauty of Ramadan, that there are many things that out of Ramadan we cannot even think of doing, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for us to practice those things during Ramadan. We have better control on our appetite, we have better control on our anger, we have better control on our nafs, we have better control on our desires, and we see barakah in our time. So Ramadan is basically a month where Allah makes it easy for us to practice so that we can be more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, our malaki part of our body, our spiritual part of our body, it gets uplifted, and our bahimi part, the animal part of our body, goes down, because we control our desires of eating, we control our worldly desires. Because of that, our bahimi, animal like our instincts, they go down, and then our malaki, angelical qualities, they go up, so we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and my sisters, you know, if we plan before Ramadan, one of the advantages, my brother, we get our reward based on intention. So if we plan today, and God forbid, if I depart from this dunya or I get sick, you know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep all of us happy and healthy so we can see this Ramadan. Like Sahaba used to pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 6 months before Ramadan, Ya Rabbul Alameen, give us opportunity that we can witness another Ramadan. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you me this tawfiq that we can witness and live through this Ramadan. But life can end anytime. So if I have a plan, I have intention to fulfill that plan, if I depart from this dunya, or I get sick, or I get, you know, busy because of unknown reasons, I will still get the reward of my intention, my brothers and my sisters. There are few things that we want to make sure during Ramadan, that we should be very time conscious. We want to make sure that we do not want to waste even a single second of Ramadan from the very beginning of Ramadan. So any activity which is just to kill the time, waste of time, no benefit, I want to make sure that I don't want to involve myself in any such activity. Number two, I want to make sure that all my prayers are going to happen with Takbir-e-Ula. For some reason, because of COVID, if I cannot go to masjid, I will make my own little musalla at home, that with whole family I will pray. No matter if I pray home because of the situation, or in the masjid, I want to make sure that every salah happens with Takbir-e-Ula, my brothers. Because you know, every fard salah, every fard we will do in Ramadan, basically you get reward of 70 to 700 times. 70 to 700 times depends on our sincerity. So number one, I want to make sure all my salah happens with Takbir-e-Ula. Number two, I want to develop a special relationship with Quran. If I have never finished Quran with translation, then I want to make sure in this Ramadan, I will finish Quran with translation. Lot of our brothers and sisters, they have this misconception that, you know, finishing Quran more than one time is more important than spending time and reading translation of Quran while you are reading the Arabic text as well. Let me share with you what Imam Ibn Taymiyyah says. He says, 1 hour of tadabbur, pondering on ayahs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, universe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 1 hour you spend in contemplation, tadabbur, pondering on ayahs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that 1 hour is better than ibadah of 1,000 years. My brothers, when you will read Quran with translation and some tafsir, you will understand the meaning of those ayahs. That will bring your iman a different level. It will uplift you, your spiritual uplifting, your spiritual growth will happen by understanding of the Quran. And you should know there are 5 rights of Quran on us. The number 1 right is that we read Quran. Number 2 right is we understand Quran. Number 3 right is that we practice Quran. And number 4 right is we propagate this message. And number 5 right is we help to establish this system of Quran around us in the universe, my brothers and my sisters. So understanding of Quran is haq on us. So if I have not finished Quran, or if I don't read Quran with translation in Ramadan, I want to plan that I will read Quran with translation, even if I will be able to finish half of the Quran or few juz of Quran. But I would like to spend some time in understanding of Quran, my brothers and my sisters. Then we have to spend time on nawafil. And you know, during Ramadan, nafil ibadah has reward of fard. So if I get opportunity of doing anything nafil, if I have opportunity to pray extra salah, so this is the month of extra salah, to get used to with extra salah. Don't miss your sunnah. Try to take care of all the nawafil and sunnah of your salah. Take care of your, you know, tarawih salah. Because tarawih salah, we don't want to go in this debate of nafil or sunnah. Brothers, in this month, nafil ibadah has reward of fard. Try to take advantage. You want to make sure that you engage in every activity possible in this month of Ramadan, which will be beneficial for you in the life hereafter. You want to make sure you keep yourself busy and engaged in all different activities of Ramadan. And same way is Qiyamul Layl. Even though Tarawih is Qiyamul Layl, but when you wake up for sahur, for your sahri, then you pray few rak'ah before you eat your sahur. So that way you get reward of tahajjud salah. And this is the month that we should try to develop some habits. Habits of getting up a little bit earlier than fajr time, so that we can pray tahajjud salah out of Ramadan as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us this opportunity in this month that we can take care of this beautiful salah of tahajjud. And this is the month of caring and giving. So make sure that you take care of not only your family, your extended family and the people around you. And when I said in the beginning that take care of things, whatever you could take care before Ramadan, one of the things is that if you know that you have to help some brothers, try to help them before Ramadan. If you have to do, you know, shopping for Eid, or you have to do other stuff in Ramadan, try to do all that before Ramadan. You know, in Muslim majority countries, you see people spend all Ramadan in shopping places, especially last 10 nights. Those nights are that we should bring more life in masajid, more life in our homes. We should be engaged more in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and my sisters, if we plan ahead, we can save all that time for our relationship with Quran, our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and our time spent in ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another thing which I want to highlight here, brothers and sisters, is dua. You know, Sayyid Qutb Shaheed Rahmatullah Alayh has mentioned in one of his books, Hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu, in which he says that Allah accepts every day and night of Ramadan one dua of every fasting person. Yani one dua during daytime accepted, and one dua during night time accepted guaranteed. So we should plan. You know, we can ask as many duas as we would like to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is not just restricted to accept few duas from us. Allah can give us without limits. But what Sayyid Qutb is saying here, we should plan to make special dua every sahur time and very special dua at every iftar time. When we are starting our fast, one dua, plan that these are the 60 duas that I want to plan, and I will go with special, you know, enthusiasm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I will make these special duas on these special times. Make list of those 60 duas, my brother. One dua every morning during your sahur, after you finish your sahur at fajr time, and one dua before you break your fast. There is another hadith of the Prophet ﷺ in which he says, Allah does not reject dua of three people, and one of those three is the fasting person before he breaks his fast. So my brothers, we should make this our priority, and this can only happen if I plan ahead that I will make these special duas during Ramadan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you and me this tawfiq, that we make this Ramadan one of the best Ramadan of our life. This Ramadan Allah makes for us as a life changer. I visualize myself, I have a mental picture in my mind that I want to be on that level, inshallah, after Ramadan. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you me tawfiq that we can witness Ramadan and we can live through Ramadan and we can benefit as much as possible from this month of Ramadan. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.